one carrying a 10-gallon bloody teapot now. She's come. Come on, girls! If you touch that, my dad's gonna kill me! Whack, 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 whack! I'm a country sort of a bloke. I like caring and sharing with people.
Sticks. There used to live a country boy, they called him Fiddlin' Picks. Now he could play most anything, and some say he could sing. But the one thing that he liked to do best was soaring on them strings. Tune up the fiddle and rosin up the bow. Look at old Pick stomping his toe. We'll make music till the rafters ring. Old man picking and a soaring on his thing, on his thing. Come on, get your hands going, folks. Had a barbecue and they all brought stuff to eat. They all had to wait on me for the frolic to be complete. When I came down from the mountain, all the gals begin to sway. Sometimes I'd pick that old five string until the break of day. So tune up the five string, tighten up the hide. Tell all the young folk to get inside. We'll make music till the rafters ring. Old man picking and a sawing on his thing. Here we go, Catholics! You want to go by yourselves? Oh, beautiful! And again. Thank you very much. Welcome to my little show, folks. Growing up here in Tamworth Country Music Capital was great when I was a kid because you used to hear all that old country music on the radio, the real country. Real country music. The W in C and W. The Western in country and Western. To see my blue-eyed Sally. She lives way down on Shinbone Alley. Number on the gate is the number on the door. The next house over is the grocery store. Stay all night, stay a little longer. Dance all night, dance a little longer. Pull up your clothes, throw them in the corner. Don't see why, don't stay a little longer. My guitar player, give him a hand. It's actually me on a night off playing with myself on the guitar. Hey! You can't go home if you're going by the mill, cause the bridge washed out at the bottom of the hill. The big creek's up and the little creek's level. I plough my corn with a double shovel. Stay all night, stay a little longer. Dance all night, dance a little longer. Pull off your clothes, throw them in the corner. Don't see why, don't stay a little longer. On the window, singing to my love. Slop bucket fell from the window up above. Mule and the grasshopper eating ice cream. Mule got sick, so it ate him on the bean. Hell, night, stay a little longer. Dance all night, dance a little longer. Pull off your clothes, throw them in the corner. Don't see why, don't stay a little longer. my piano player. One finger Tess. She's good. Have a listen to this. You know what? More people would have learned to play the piano had the keys been on the other side. Grab your old girl and pat her on the head. If she don't like biscuits, feed her cornbread. Girls up the creek, about half grown. Jump on a man like a dog on a bone. Stay all night, stay a little longer. Dance all night, dance a little longer. Pull off your coat, throw it in the corner. Don't see why don't stay a little longer. Stay a little longer, dance all night. Dance a little longer, pull off your coat. Throw it in the corner, don't see why don't stay a little longer.
My mum and dad loved the old country music. They loved it. But my mum's favourite country singer, and you're all supposed to spontaneously go, when I tell you, my mum's favourite country singer was Doris Day. Oh. You fakers. but for the want of another vowel. My mother's favourite country singer was Doris Day. Oh, I got Doris Day in, day out when I was a kid by the age of 8. I was wearing the little red gingham frock, looked fabulous. But, I'd sit down and they go, what? No, that was fabulous. My father used to call Doris Day the Eternal Virgin. You know why, don't you? You know why?
Why?
Glad you asked. You know why? Because she was hanging out with that Rock Hudson fella. Nothing going on there. My mother's favourite Doris Day song. Have a listen to this. See if you remember. Remember this great old tune.
I wasn't ready.
Once I had a secret love. That burned within the heart of me. And all too soon my secret love became impatient to be freed. So I told a passing star, woo, the way that dreamers often do. Just how wonderful you are. Why I'm so in love with you. Now I shouted from the highest hill. I even told the golden daffodil. Shut up, it's my song. At last my heart's an open book. My secret love's no secret. And all.
Big violin solo by a little fiddler.
From the highest hill. Oh, I even told the golden daffodil. At last my heart's an open.
You'll get the fiddle stick in a minute.
My secret love's no secret anymore.
Ah.
I just love that old stuff. It was great because, many of the old fiddle instrumentals you don't hear much anymore because everybody's turned to the rock and roll and bloody bluegrass. And you know what bluegrass is, don't you? You know what bluegrass is? Bluegrass. Oh, I'll make something up, bloody bluegrass. Thank you.
do that. The hard stuff, the really difficult stuff, is the stuff not many of them do anymore. The hard stuff is that beautiful old country fiddle that everybody used to listen to at all the old dances years ago. That's the hard stuff. I'm going to do one of the most difficult of the old tunes for you. It's a beautiful thing for the Catholic girls. Down on your knees and genuflect. This is the fabulous Maiden's Prayer. Ah, the Maiden's Prayer. Have a go at this. I love this. One of my favourite tunes. You old string bender. It's in stereo, you know. You got two bloody ears, haven't you? Ladies and gentlemen, one finger test on the piano. Have a listen to this. She's only got one bloody finger, that's why. Why she wets the end of it. Perhaps it just gets a bit dry. Key change. That's the stuff. That's the stuff country music dreams were made of, folks. That wonderful old country music sound. I might keep you there just for a little bit, folks, and do one of my favourite tunes for you. And it's probably one of the world's oldest popular fiddle tunes. It's a little thing, and please erupt into spontaneous oohs and ahs of admiration when I tell you the name. This is called I Pump the Audience. It's better to have one of those applause signs. I mean, you must be a really terrible act to have an applause sign, haven't you? Now you got to clap now. Oh, God. This is a little thing called the Hot Canary. I've nicknamed this for Australian conditions. It's now called the Flamin' Budgie. The Flamin' Budgie, the Hot Canary. You will please notice that there are no safety nets, so don't try this at home, kids. It's a very difficult tune. You might poke someone's eye out. This has got... You wouldn't want to get too close. You'd puncture. Like that. Here it is. Well, you're sitting there in the front. It's not my fault. Have you been told about coming to my shows? You didn't bring the black plastic either because you're going to... Oh, no. I'm going to... Because I spit a lot, apparently. And you will sit down the front. Are you well protected, are you? Those ads are working. Really. The Hot Canary. Have a listen to this. Thank you.
pizzicato. Get back in your cage, you flaming budgie. I grew up in Tamworth here, as I keep telling you. I sat on the veranda every day when I was a kid. I sat on the veranda every day mimicking all the bush bird noises I heard around the place. So I come up with things like the pink and grey glass flying overhead. Look, Mum. The whip bird. Bloody kookaburras. Thank you very much. The Hot Canary, or nicknamed for Australian conditions, the Flamin' Budgie. I got into trouble for making all those noises when I was a kid at school. The nuns hated me and I hated the nuns. There's a mutual thing going on there. Because I was a bit of a larrikin at school.
Never.
Oh, yeah. Oh, I don't know, take her home, she's ready. I used to make all the noises in the class, and music class at school. Nuns hated me. Look at me knuckles, I've got nothing left. And whack over the back of the knuckles if I played up. Oh, it was terrible. I used to make all sorts of noises, make the other kids laugh in the class, and I was the one who invented the immortal. Me, I invented that. Nun farted. It was her father. Oh, there she goes again. The ambulance. They hated the ambulance. The hills hoist. They hated the bloody hills hoist. Hold on, put a bit of wind with it. Listen to this, you go. Oh, shit, that's lonely. Oh, I used to make all sorts of noises, and they used to hate me for it, I suppose, but I used to love having fun with it, because you come up with... Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, folks and folkettes, cowboys and cowgirls, blokes and sheilas, budgies and wedgies, same-sex couples. Will you welcome back to the stage, please? Five times gold guitar winning me! Fabulous intro. Hands up the Pixie Virgins. Hands up the people who haven't seen me before. Hands up the Pixie Virgins. Oh, fabulous. I can do the spiel. For those people who haven't seen me before, this is for you. Others, ignore it. Pixie Jenkins is the name, fiddling's the game, and I come from Tamworth Country Music Capital. I've spent the last 27 years in the Australian country music industry, and over that 27 years, I have been nominated in the Australian Country Music Awards 18 times a finalist, 5 times gold guitar winner.
Not only, but also, I'm an inductee to the Australian Country Music Hands of Fame. I go down and brush it out every day. I've been down on my knees, well, for various reasons, but one particular time at Maguire's Pub to be inducted into the Australian Country Music Noses of Fame. Yay! I'm in that. Oh, you can swim in bloody Chad Morgan's nose print when it rains, I tell you now. Fabulous. And in January last year, we immortalised another body part in cement. What do you think it was? No. It's the Hall Country Music, the Australian Country Music Hall of Backsides. Oh, and we asked Tanya Kernigan to make the first impression. Down she went. Cement flying, kids crying, dogs barking. They give you this little stick to sign your name in the wet cement, little ceremonial mulga wood stick with your name on it. Tanya Kernigan. The only thing she had to worry about was where she dotted the I. That would have been an unfortunate country music media moment. I'm going to do a little classical music to start the second half of the show off. A little classical music. Hope you don't mind. This is written by the notorious old Puff Tchaikovsky. It's called The Nutcracker. Oh! He must have wrote this at Christmas time. It's called The Nutcracker. It's called The Nutcracker, as featured on Cowboys and Cowgirls. Troy Dan's Outback Adventures. Troy Dan's Outback at the sneaky little bloke from the top end. You know, he's got arms thicker than my legs. Troy Dan, sneaky little bloke from the top end. He featured it on his Outback Adventures program on the ABC in the episode where he dived into the pool in the little black G-string. Did you see that one? You videotaped it. I can tell by the reaction. It's a really little outback moon shining northwards. And I tell people... I tell people that have never been west of Strathfield, I say to them, listen, if you've never been west of Strathfield, for Christ's sake, pack that little black G-string. It's good enough for Troy, it's good enough for you. Driving your bloody Touareg tractor around. Here it is anyway. Double bay, double bogey. This is called the Nut. Oh, I wasn't ready. Do it again, I wasn't ready. Do it again. What am I talking to you for? Nutcracker. Stay on for 8 seconds in your mind. Boots good, I chucked it in for free. Tchaikovsky. I'm going to do
a little song. As I told you, growing up in Tamworth was great because you used to get all those wonderful old dances, you know, the Maryland Shoddies and the Canadian three-step and the Valita Waltz, the Pride of Air and the Gypsy Tap, the Margarita, the Princess Waltz. I love the Princess Waltz. My mother's favourite dance, the Foxtrot. But we used to have a fabulous time. A fabulous time doing all those old dances. And I don't know about you, but I used to love going to the dance, but I'm not so sure as a virile young country lad growing up in Tamworth, country music capital, a virile young country lad, I'm not so sure I went to the dances for the dancing. No, I'm not so sure I went to the dances for the dancing. You know what I went for, don't you? Yes, the tucker. The tucker. Because at half-time, Big Fat Maud, the Sergeant Major of the CWA, would lead the women's auxiliary out down the... Come on, girls! Half-time! Come on, quick! She'd be the one carrying the 10-gallon bloody teapot. Now she'd come... Come on, girls! Down and go the butcher paper. Out go the trestle tables. Down and go the butcher paper. And all the little plates of food that everybody had brought would get put out and you'd file around going, ah, oh, the chocolate crackles and the lamingtons and the fairy bread and the butterfly cakes and the raspberry and lemon tarts and the dippy little boys in the sauce. And some cheap mongrel would have gone to Bilo and bought a pack of iced Vovos and whacked them on the table. My dad had called me over and he'd stick his finger through the plastic of the egg sandwiches. Son, come over here, listen to this. And he'd go, you touch those, your mother can drive you home. My mum used to get a great thrill out of seeing Big Fat Maud and Little Pixie dance together. I just want to get this picture in your head, right? Oh, Christ. Traditionally, after all the supper, right? Traditionally, after all the half-time supper, what would happen is the band, Frank Burke and his wife, would start up in the first of the progressive barn dances of the night. That's the dance. If you come with some sheila you didn't like, you go home with somebody else, that's fine. Big Fat Maud loved the progressive barn dance. She was the first out on the floor, and she got to dance with all the blokes. Oh, she loved it. And if they only got halfway around, she'd pay the band another $10, so she'd go in again. Oh, it was lovely. But just imagine this, right? My mother would push me out on the floor because Big Fat Maud was up. She'd push me out the floor giggling. Go on, giddy up. Big, tiny, tiny little me. Big Fat Maud. Big Fat Maud. Tiny, tiny little me. There I was, happily dancing around, doing 10 steps to everybody else's one. And then Big Fat Maud would be the next partner. Bang! Me feet would be dangling off the floor. Me head cocooned between two massive Johnson baby powdered breasts. And I'd be yelling, Mum, help! Mum, help! No, wouldn't I be going, talcum powder wafting into the air. Always used to... I always used to get my hands stuck in the roll of fat between the girdle and the bra strap. She'd swing me around for 5 or 6 partner changes before she realised I was hanging off her. Get out, you little mongrel. Thank you very much. You know, one Sunday morning, I distinctly remember one Sunday morning after the Saturday night dance, My dad and mum are out the back. Well, dad's out the front reading the newspaper. Mum's out the back mowing the lawn. And some of the women went, yeah, typical, yeah. Dad's on the front round reading the newspaper. Mum's out the back mowing the lawn. And I'm in the kitchen sneaking around. I'm in the kitchen bloody sneaking around. So I've gotten into the cupboard that holds the sacred family heirloom. The only thing of value we have is this old wax roll gramophone record player. Beautiful old thing. With the ivory HMV logo and everything. Fabulous. Worth a bloody fortune, so my father keeps telling me. It was wonderful because I got this thing out. Contrary to everything my father had ever bloody said to me. In fact, I remember my father saying to me from a very early age, if you touch that, I'll kill you, little bastard. And there I was, lying back, looking up at him from me cot. He started into me early because he knew I was going to grow up to be a mongrel. Anyway, I've snuck in and I've got this thing out of the cupboard and put it on the kitchen table and started putting it together. Oh, got the big brass bell and whacked it in the hole. Opened up the calipers and got the... Oh, it was something else. Yeah, opened up the calipers and put the wax roll in. Got the needle over onto it. Started winding it up and winding and winding and winding. And about 5 seconds, 10, 20 seconds later, all of a sudden, it went ping, tang, ding, spang, dong, dick, dock, dackle, ting. Springs and screws and bits of wood and stuff flew all over the bloody kitchen, and I stood there, went wide as a ghost, started shaking and put me trousers. Because I'm thinking, my dad's going to kill me. No, what have I done? And I heard Mum and Dad wondering what all the noise is. They're coming in. So I'm racing around all over the bloody kitchen, picking up cat hair and cigarette butts and anything looked like it should be in there, whacking it in the box, shoved it back in the cupboard and stood there looking real innocent, picking my nose as Mum and Dad came in the kitchen. Dad said, "What's all that bloody noise?" I've gone, "Nothing." I didn't hear nothing. Now, I must have got away. I look really innocent. I must have got away with it. I look really innocent. Oh, I must have got away with it. Because, I remember about three or four, you forget things as a kid. You forget things. If you've done something wrong, for Christ's sake, write it down, kids. Stick it under the bed so you remember. You don't get caught out that way. 3 or 4 months later, we're sitting around the Christmas table. 3 or 4 months, I've forgotten all about it. 3 or 4 months later, sitting around the Christmas table, and Dad gets up, burps and farts, and goes, "Edna!" "Edna!" "Come over here. Get the old wax roll gramophone record player out and have a little dance around the Christmas table, darling." You know what I'm doing, don't you? I'm over in the corner, turning white, shaking. I put my trousers again. I go, "Oh, no, I've forgotten all about it. I'm going to get killed. Dad's going to find out it's Christmas time. I'm going to go with presents. Oh, no." And he's gone over to the cupboard. He's opened the cupboard up and done one of those Hollywood double takes. He's looked in the cupboard. He's looked up at Mum. He's looked in the cupboard. He's looked up at Mum. And then they both turned to look at the spot where I was standing. Not 5 seconds. I'm off. As fast as my little legs carry, my dad's voice trailing off in the background. "I'll get you when you least expect it, you little bastard!" You know what, though? I never expected it. I could never work it out. I never expected it. 3 days later, he's cornered me between the carrots, lettuce and back fence. "Good day, little fella. Where are you going?" "Come and give your old dad a hug. Come on." "No, come on." Now, I always got sucked in by this routine. I'm thinking, he's forgotten. He's bloody forgotten. As soon as I got within arm's length, it was whack, 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 until I got away for another bloody 3 weeks. The only trouble is punters and puntettes. The only trouble is this went on for 33 bloody years. My old dad passed away in June. He passed away in June this year. No, it was good because, he didn't... I think I was very fortunate. I hope some of you don't take this the wrong way, but I think I was very fortunate. He went across the road for a chocolate gay time, came back over, sat down and passed away. Oh, that was great, you know? It was great. He was 86 year old. And, it was really, really good because he just passed away, as it were, not lingered. And... you know, you don't like talking about these things, but I'm a country sort of a bloke. I like caring and sharing with people. What are you laughing about? Me dad's bloody died. He's laughing. Put the camera on her. See, he's laughing. Now back to me. It's my show. But I might do a little song for me old dad, and my dad loved the old country music.
Tribbler.
It's the kids.
Is it me and you? Is it Mum and Dad? Is it a cockatoo?
One kid there can't sing, listen.
Is it standing by your mate?
Big fat Queensland mother, I'm not going to argue with
her.
My kid sings in your choir. Yeah, okay.
Or
sound of the old country dobro. You old countdowners. Is it mom and dad? Come on up the back, everybody.
Is it a cockatoo? Is it standing by your mate? Oh yeah, when he's in a fight. Or just Vegemite.
Thank you very much. Of course, over that 25 years in Australian country music, 27 years, as I told you before, I've actually been John. Get some Singer sewing machine oil out for that. Was that your hip or the chair? My hip squeaks. Listen, come here. You get into trouble, I tell you, couldn't you? But I've been John Williamson's fiddle player for 22 years. And over that 22 years, I've played on nearly all of his albums. The one album that I couldn't play on, I was out in the middle of the sticks somewhere and he couldn't find me. But it's been a great association, not only John as a mate, but to see a mate rise to such stardom as John Williamson has in Australia has been extraordinary. And I think most of you will agree that John Williamson is certainly one of our great songwriters today. Many people, of course, have paid tribute to John Williamson's songwriting, but not many people have paid tribute to the wonderful, wonderful melodies that he's writes. So I'm going to do that for you right now. Wish me luck with it, folks. It's called Cootamundra Wattle. Let me take you down there. With the full 90-piece Adelaide Symphony Orchestra. Lindsay Butler on guitar, folks. Give him a hand. I'll tell him you did. Thank you.
I might do another little track that's off the album for you. Another track that's off the album. It's a great track, written, of course, by John Williamson and myself. And a little story about this one, because we were having a little, as there is about everything, but we were having a barbecue one day. We decided to have a barbecue, as you do when you travel west to Strathfield. You want to pull over beside the roadside. We dug a hole. We quickly filled it in because it stunk, and we drove up 200 metres. Keep up, Catholics. We dug another hole. We dug another hole, snuck around for some gidgey wood, got it in the hole and got it all burning up nice. Pulled the grill out of the back of the F100, put it across the fire. While waiting for the barbecue to get hot enough, we reached into the back of the Eskies, pulled out a couple of tinnies of 4X. God, I hate that stuff. Oh, no, I do. It's a horror. How do you stand it? Is it? Oh, don't talk to me about it. 4X is for poison. Don't touch that crap. Either that or you can't spell beer in Queensland. It's all right, I'm a Tasmanian. I get enough of it, don't you worry. Born in Launceston, grew up in Tamworth. My God, that's a mixture. But after, 5 or 10 minutes go by, not a cloud in the sky. Beautiful day, not a cloud in the sky. We decided to get you lift the tit on the Tupperware container, the little titty, the tab! Sorry about the tit thing. You lift the tab on the Tupperware container, and as soon as the fumes of the sausages exude into the outback air, the nemesis of the Australian barbecue flies upon the scene. Oh, Christ, one mongrel blowfly. 500 miles from the closest homestead, one blowfly has to fly. Quick, see if you can kill it before it brings its bloody mates. Nah, you've been drinking that 4X. You've got to admit the fly's a bit faster than you. You go about your business, you try to ignore the mongrel, So you start telling dirty jokes and stuff like that, and about 5 minutes go by and all of a sudden the little bastard will stop. You haven't been paying attention, you don't know where it's landed. It's on the sausages, but you don't know. And you sneak around wondering where the little mongrel is, and all of a sudden you think you've got a bead on it. Next minute, oh, it's off again, look out! We had a bloody enough of this. You know what we did? We kicked sand on the fire and we headed off back. No, I can't tell a lie. We peed on the fire. We did. We peed on the fire. As you do, as blokes do in the bush. You pee on the fire like this and then you write your name in the red dust with the residual. P. I. How am I going to do the X? Oh, wait on. Look at that. Jeez, that's. Look at that. See? And then you've got to dot the I's. Ha ha. Oh, it wasn't my handwriting. Anyway, we headed off back to Kununurra, where we had a beautiful afternoon underneath the gazebo with a bottle of Fruity Lexia and some cheese sticks. Here it is, a lovely little thing called The Flight of the Blowfly. Oh, I got the wrong floppy dick in. Didn't even look, that went straight in. Here it is, The Flight of the Blowfly. It goes something like this. You ready? Where is it? Get out of it, you mongrel. Hit it with the Aragard can. The flight of the blowfly. Landing strip.
And here I got you, little mongrel.
The flight of the blowfly. I might I might do a little song that is very dear to my heart, written by a great woman of Australia, Dorothea McKellar. Dorothea McKellar wrote one of the most beautiful, important pieces of prose that's ever been written about this great country of ours. Dorothea McKellar wrote the immortal words, "I love a sunburnt country, a land of sweeping plains, of ragged mountain ranges, of droughts and flooding rains. I love her far horizons. I love her jewel seas, her beauty and her terror, this wide brown land for me." And she wrote that in 1904, folks, and no truer words been spoken about this great country of ours. You're hot, love. Fanning, you're hot. It's the hormones racing, you know, it is. I get the same thing, I have hot flushes, the hormones. Oh. You get 40. Well, 40 odd. Over 40 and I'm odd. But you get to... No, you do. You get to that time and you start getting lumps and bumps and stuff where you didn't want them. And no matter what you do, you cut them off. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? It's the hormones. It's the bloody hormones. My mum was looking fantastic, though. She was looking bloody fantastic. She was taking that HRT. Hormone replacement therapy. HR bloody T. So I thought, she's looking fantastic. I'll pinch some of that. Take that. I'll take that. So I took it and I was taking the Viagra at the same time. I didn't know whether I was coming or going. Didn't know whether I was coming or going, I'm telling you now. Pulling myself apart. Right, I'm going to do a little song here. This is it. Written by... Oh, get in trouble. Written by Dorothea McKellar. My country, my music. If you've never heard the full poem, have a listen to this. Oh, the love of field and coppice, of green and shaded lanes, of ordered woods and gardens, is running through your veins. Strong love of grey-blue distance, brown streams and soft dim skies. I know but cannot share it, my love is otherwise. I love a sunburnt country, a land of sweeping plains, of a ragged mountain ranges, of droughts and flooding rains. I love her far horizons, I love her jewel seas, her beauty and her terror, this wide brown land for me. You see the tragic ringbark forest, stark white beneath the moon, the sapphire misted mountains, or the hot gold hush of noon, green tangle of the brushes, where live lianas coil, and orchids deck the treetops, and ferns the crimson soil. Core of my heart, my country, her pitiless blue sky. When sick at heart around us, we see our cattle die. But then the grey clouds gather, we can bless again the drumming of an army or the steady soaking rain. You know I love a sunburnt country, a land of sleeping plains, of ragged mountain ranges, of droughts and flooding rains. I love the far horizons, I love her jewel seas, her beauty and her spirit, this wide brown land for me. My heart, my country, land of the rainbow gold, for flood, for fire, for famine, she pays us back threefold. Over the thirsty paddocks, watch after many days, the filmy veil of greenness that thickens as we gaze. It's an opal-hearted country, a willful, lavish land. All those who have not loved her, you couldn't understand. Though earth holds many splendors, wherever I may die, I know to what brown country my homing thoughts will fly.
You see, I love a sunburned country, a land of sweeping plains, of ragged mountain ranges, of droughts and flooding rains. I love her far horizons, I love her jewel seas, her beauty and her terror, this wide brown land for me. Sing up, little possums, come on. I love a sunburned country, a land of sweeping plains, of a ragged mountain ranges, of droughts and flooding rains. I love her far horizons, I love her jewel seas, her beauty and her terror, this wide brown land for me.
Thank you very much. I might do a song that I wrote when I was a young fella growing up here in Tamworth, and it means more to me now than it ever does. It's a little thing called Young at Heart, or I've subtitled, as the years go by, Younger Tart. If you can't beat 'em, join 'em. He looked up from the ground and he reached for the sky. There he found a peace of mind. He was high. Though he was older now, he still found a way of reaching his goals well before the night turned to day. Lay a while, stay a while, keep me company. You're the one who loved with me when we were both young and free. Though the years have sped on by, I'm still so close to you. Please be near me now, we're still young at heart. You know that's true. As dawn pulls back the covers, sleeping country lay. He tried and tried so hard to understand. As night became the day, morning came. One with a sigh, he looked back down to the ground. And as the sun peeped through the hills, he left without a sound. Lay a while, stay a while, keep me company. You're the one who laughed with me when we were both young and free. Though the years been on by, I'm still so close to you. Please be near me now, we're still young at heart. You know that's true. Say you want to keep me company. We're still young at heart. Stay a while, keep me company. We're still young at heart. Stay a while, keep me company. We're still young at heart. Stay a while, keep me company. Thank you very much, folks. One of my own songs, a little thing called Young at Heart. A little song for you to finish off. I had the great pleasure of meeting Charlie Daniels when he came to Tamworth 4 years ago. And Charlie, of course, is a legendary American country music artist and has been a fiddle player over there for 30, 40 years, and one of the great Southern Texas rockers as well. But the thing I found about Charlie Daniels that was nicer than anything was the fact that he was just such a great bloody bloke. And we had the great fortune of playing four shows together over at the Leagues Club. Did anybody see those a couple of years ago? But I was on the Country Music Awards of Australia with him as well. He walked in from one side, I came in from the other, looking really fabulous in the purple jacket. And he played a lick, I played a lick, he played a lick, I played a lick, and we met in the centre. My nose went straight into his belly button. That's how bloody big that man is. He's a man mountain. My nose went straight into his belly button. He looked down, you're the strangest goddamn little thing I've ever seen. But we had four great shows together at the Leagues Club, and I'm going to do a little song for you now, which has been Charlie Daniels' song for some, I don't know, since he brought it out in 1972. And I have been doing it ever since. And still to date, ladies and gentlemen, still to date, I am the only fiddle player that can sing it, dance it, play it, and think about what I'm having for bloody breakfast at the same time. So here we go. This is called The Devil Came Down to Tamworth. That's my version of it. It's my version of it. The Devil Came Down to Tamworth. Set it up, mate. Here we go. The Devil came down to Tamworth. He was looking for a soul to steal. He was in a bind because he's way behind and willing to make a deal with any bugger. Well, he came across this young bloke, saw him in the fiddle and shit, he was good. The devil jumped up in his blackened stump and started to finger his Christmas pud. Well, guess you didn't know it, but I'm a fiddle player too. And if you care to take this dare, I'll make a bet with you. Now you play pretty good fiddle, son, but give the devil his due. Better fiddle a gold against your little thingo, because I think I'm better than you. Boy said, my name's Pixie, it might be a sin. Take your bet, you're gonna get... Pixie, rosin up your bow and play your fiddle hard. Cause I'll blow blues from Tamworth and the devil heals a card. If you win, you get that shiny fiddle made of gold. If you lose, the devil gets your soul. Opened up his case and said, oh, I'll start this show. And fire blew from his fingertips as he rosined up his little bow. And he drew the bow across the strings and made an evil hiss. Oh. And a band of demons joined in. It sounded something like this. You come here often? For the mums at home. When the devil finished, Pixie said, well, that's shit house.
Fire on the mountain, run, boys, run. Devil's in the house of the rising sun. Chicken in the bedpan, picking out dough. Granny sees your dog cries, no child, no. Come on, help him out, folks. Well, the devil bowed his head, cause he knew that he'd been beat, and he laid that golden fiddle on the ground at Pixie's little feet. And Pixie said, oh, come on back if you want to try it again, cause I told you once, you big fat Tex, and I'm the best that's ever been. Fire on the mountain, run, boys, run. Devil's in the house of the rising sun. Chicken in the bed, bam, picking up gold. Granny sees your dog, boys, no child, no. Woo! Woo! Everybody! bucks. Thanks very much. More! 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 Oh, shit. More! I wonder if I noticed I did that. More! Oh, what, for me?
G'day folks, Pixie Jenkins here. Thanks very much for buying the video. Hope to see you at one of my shows sometime. Until then.
Well, Pixie Jenkins, 5 times Golden Guitar winner, 2 times Instrumentalist of the Year, Tamworth's Country Music Ambassador. What more can you say? One of the great entertainers of country music and one of the greatest fiddle players that we'll ever have. Pixie!
Goodness, wouldn't that be nice all the time? I had a great time last year this year at the Toyota Tamworth Country Music Awards when I had the great pleasure of playing with one of the legends of American music, a big fella. We had a face-to-face meeting, actually it was face-to-naval meeting, really. Cut it out. Charlie Daniels. And we never got to finish the job. So I'm going to ask my musical compadre, Andrew Claremont, to come out, folks, and give us a hand. To give us a hand on a great old Charlie Daniels tune that you'll probably all know, called The Devil Came Down to Tamworth. Sold a steal. He was in a bind because he's way behind and willing to make a deal with anybody. He came across this young bloke, saw him in a fiddle, and geez, he was good. The devil jumped up on his blackened stump and said, "Boy, let me tell you what, I guess you didn't know it, but I'm a fiddle player too. And if you care to take this dare start this show. And fire blew from his fingertips and he rosin up his little bow. And he drew the bow across the strings and it made an evil hiss. And a band of demons joined in and it sounded something like this. Ho! Yeah. Again, because I told you once a miserable bludger on the best has ever been, and he played. I'm on the man.